Mr. Quince.
Thank you. good day on the Bream today, down here at Argal where I live. Just caught my second. Unfortunately, the ultimate worst thing in the world just happened. That could happen when you catch a bream. Lands on my chair. I got a wet stinking bream ass. Never mind, eh? Anyway, I think we're going to be into a few. Seems like tiger nuts are the way to go. Show you how I'm setting up for the bream today. So I didn't really start by saying. So I'm using this PVA mesh. Looks a bit like this. Check it out. So kind of like that. I've tied a knot on the end, and there's the plunger. What I'm doing is bait. What I've got in there is we've got tiger nuts, we've got dynamite bait, I can't remember which one, sweet corn, and a load of this, which is PVA friendly. It's oil basically, so it doesn't melt the mesh. What you do is just put a bit in the end like that. This is going to be hard one-handed. Think about this. And then you plunge down the end. How am I going to do this one-handed? So the mesh, we got the mix in there. What you do is you put your thumb over the end, plunge it down, sort of stab it in there. Just pop it out the end like that. Take this, tie a knot. Pull the knot in close, cut like that, put it in close, put another knot, two knots. You definitely need the two knots. So you've got two knots like that. Get your scissors, which will save you the foam, and cut in between those two knots. Right. Attach it, you get your needle, you put it through one corner, out the other.
Are you bud?
You alright there?
Any luck?
I've had three bream so far.
Oh, you're doing better than I did. I had one on the other side.
I've got one in short, and I've got the old school here. Like far out, and I'm getting them all on that one. So I'm setting up like this, PVA netting and some oil and stuff.
Well, just... the bigger ones come on the boilers.
Oh, I'm not using boilers, I'm using tiger nuts.
Oh, yeah. Rubber egg, isn't it?
They're doing a... they seem to be doing a job.
Tiger nuts?
Yeah.
What are you doing yourself?
Yeah, I just boil, get them from a health food place and just boil them up. Soak them for a couple of days, then boil them up. About 20 minutes and that's it.
I am lazy. And I haven't got a very understanding missus when it comes to getting baits ready.
She helps me with it.
So I see how you're lucky. I usually buy mine in, and they're in an oil.
So oh, right.
PVA friendly.
Oh, right.
So you can actually put them straight into the PVA bag as well, you know.
I've made my own. I've got this dynamite bait of sweet corn and tiger nuts, and I use this PVA friendly. It's a bloodworm.
Yeah.
Put that in there.
I've had two carp out of here, and both of them have been up with them.
Yeah.
In the bay there.
Well, hopefully. Hopefully I'll catch one. Be interesting to catch one on this old fiberglass rod,
yeah?
Number 5. Not as big as some of the others, but croaking. Still pretty cool. Not a skimmer. thought I'd do a little bit of me talking here for a minute. I'm thinking about packing up. I've had 7 bream today. It's been pretty good. But I am hot. And I've probably got sunburn as well. I thought it was going to be cloudy, a bit wet today, but it's never what the forecast says it's going to be, is it? So I've been a boiling hot bivvy. But it's been a good day. I'd say the bream, probably around about 2 pound, nothing massive, but I know there's really big bream in there, really big boy stuff. So I think I'll keep at it, and you know, if I catch a carp, I catch a carp. I'll show you guys when I get it, but I'm kind of, because of, I have kind of short days, I don't do nights because of the kids and stuff like that, and so I kind of aim for the bream, but I'm kind of aiming for the carp as well. I'll catch anything, basically, is what I'm saying. Because it's just more fun. And this place I'm fishing near, Argal Reservoir, is literally just around the corner from me, so I'm going to have to get some more videos done down here, aren't I? Cheers.